Yes, so as Angel eloquently put, we have talked about Kabbalah, and actually there is a Kabbalah tree and Sephiroth, and those things are there. Those are deeper mental states and spiritual states. I hope you can see my screen, Charles and Angel.
Yes.
Okay, so this we found only today. I mean, it was right there on the top. It was actually quite small, so we had to really zoom in, increase service to others and be more loving and all that. So what we had done was we have simply typed it out. We simply typed it out. Increase your service to others. That's what she was saying. So it is all there. I mean, and definitely all this. So we will be talking about, the mental states, you know, the spiritual states, and how meditation helps you. So there is this famous professor, a scientific man, Dr. David Hawkins, PhD. So he has spoken about, you know, healing and also the vibrational states of your consciousness. So for example, if you are vibrating 20 or 30,
sorry, Partha, to interrupt, your voice is not fine.
Yeah, you keep coming in and out.
But is it better now?
Yes.
Is it better now?
Yes, much better.
Okay, please stop me if my voice is not coming out clear. Okay?
Okay.
So these are the various states of you know, consciousness vibration, which he has given a table. So this Angel will cover a little later. I mean, she will go into depth. But basically, one important thing is, you know, this number 47 or 74, which I will be showing you why it is so important. So the mantra Om, it vibrates at this frequency, so above 700. So as you can see in this table, the enlightenment frequency is basically between 700 to 1000. I think she got this information about 740, the mantra Om. And also she will talk about these things. And the optimal timeline, 47. So 74, 47 are one and the same thing. So I will decode a bit about what is 74, what is 47. So I'll talk a bit about that. And what is optimal reality. So let me go to internet. Okay, so the number 47 actually is a very mystical number, a very important number. It started appearing in the last November, December timeframe. So in fact, it was Angel only who actually pointed me out that this number 47 she saw in an ad. And then I suddenly I understood or decoded that this 47 is actually the union of two opposites, yin and yang. And when the two opposites, yin and yang, they realize each other or they recognize each other, then what happens?
Yes.
You know, it becomes a kind of chariot. Are you able to hear me, Charles?
Yes, perfectly.
Yeah. So I'll just show you that. So as you can clearly see, there is a white and a black. Again, the ad is coming. 1 second. Okay. Can you see this white and black and the chariot?
Yes.
Yes. So this is a tarot. And of course, you know, Angel can explain this better. But basically, this is a mystical symbol. It talks about, you know, a brave warrior standing inside. He wears the crescent moons. Okay. And he basically tries to control the opposites. It is not, the word control may not be right, but it's actually more about, you know, trying to get a divine balance between the two things. So notice how the sphinxes are pulling in opposite directions, but the charioteer uses his willpower and sheer resolve to steer the chariot forward. So this is actually 47. So I will tell you how it is 47. So let me just show you some news. So this I'll show a little later. These are all related to astrology. Okay, so recently Cameron Diaz, she gave birth to a child at the age of 47. Okay. They knew why, what. See, they thought simply it is a news. But now you see this. It doesn't matter in which part of the world you are in. Okay. You will see this number 47 in your consciousness. The patient leaves hospital after 47 days stay. Student tests into D47 schools. J&K, 47 people died. 47 medium and small medium enterprises feel alternative financing options. So all are unrelated news. Something is related to medical, pharma, something is related to sports. Now see, Midwestern State women's hoops coach dies at the age of 47. And we have been seeing this 47 since last 6 months. I mean, almost every day there is one news about 47. This is how the matrix codes work. So those people who have taken the red pill, maybe this year or last year, or maybe like me, maybe 20 years ago. So 20 years ago, I was the Lone Ranger because I was the only guy who was seeing, anomalies in the matrix when the Matrix movie came. In fact, when I saw the movie Matrix, I told my friends, is it possible we are sleeping somewhere? Is it possible we are connected to this simulation? Is it a simulated reality? They just, poo-pooed me.
Yeah. Now, I remember walking out of the Matrix blown away. And same thoughts.
Yes. Now, if you can see this. White House says Trump was offended by Romney's 47. 47% quote. Blackmore bond investors to get only 5 million back from 47. Wheat harvested annually, farm fires dropped by 47%. Now somebody may tell me that, maybe if you search 48, you will get all the 48 news. Maybe if you search 33, you will get 33 news, but that's not the point.
Right.
The weather temperature to hit 47 degrees. Allen County or Alien County, 47, 2 hours ago. 47 buffs name. So I will show you some screenshots from a presentation which I made on 47. Hope you can see this.
Yes.
So just tell me when you're... So New Mexico, 47, 4 new deaths. Man dies at Srinagar Hospital, 47. 47. What is this 47? The 47 has multiple meanings. So one of the very important meaning is that it is swastika. So a lot of people who hate Hitler and that time of the era when they were, when he was having that reverse swastika, please pardon me. Now, my point is not to bring in that thing into the consciousness. Mm-hmm. Actually, swastika is a very, very, very good thing.
Yeah, it is. He just...
So, as per Hindu thing, it was defiled or something, you can say.
Yes.
So, Angel had done some video in which he actually showed her that, 47 looks like swastika. So maybe she can show it a little later, but actually this swastika is nothing, but actually it is.
Bartha, I sent you on WhatsApp just the video and you can see the description.
Okay, fine. And even in, you know, in it's not related only to the Hindu philosophy or Indians about 47. See, for example, the last miracle of Jesus is 1447, Mark 1447. Or Mark 47. Okay? So, we are not going back to the times, ancient times. So, Angel sent me a video. I'm opening it quickly. So, again, see, even the, I'll show you something interesting. See, 104 views on 17th April. So, this also has 4-7. In QMAP, they talk about optimal timeline reality. They are actually talking about 47. So I'll go quickly go to the time where she actually shows. Here it is. So I'll pause it also. Can you see now?
Yes.
The video which she made. If you see, it looks like 47. See, this is 7 and this is 4. She made a beautiful video on this. So I suggest people can actually look at this because it also talks about the Jesus 47 miracles or some 47 association, also swastika. All these things she has spoken. So if you come to the ancient epics like Mahabharata and also the ancient books, so Krishna, who is a Hindu god, he says in the chapter number 4, verse number 7, whenever there is a decline in righteousness and an increase in unrighteousness, O Arjuna, at that time I manifest myself on the earth. Okay. It, in Sanskrit, it is like yada yada hi dharmasya. It is the most famous verse actually in the book. I mean, it is, as I said, you know, Bhagavad Gita is one part of the Mahabharata, and Mahabharata itself is 18 books. Each book are like, you know, some thousands of verses. So in the, all those verses, this is the most famous one which every Indian knows. Yada yada hi dharmasya. So whenever there is a decline in righteousness, at that time, I manifest. So when we are seeing 47, what does it mean? Jesus is coming or Krishna is coming. Okay. And 48, to protect the righteous, to annihilate the wicked and to reestablish the principles of dharma. So yesterday we saw dharma, Charlie, the 777, right, Charles? So dharma, actually, it means swastika. It means the truth. It means the pole star. I appear on this earth age after age. By the way, my house number is 418.
Really?
Yes. And my house number has always been 4. Either it has been 103 or 013, 13, or like now where I'm staying right now, it is 418. Always.
Yes.
And I never noticed it. I noticed it only when I started seeing 47 from December onwards. I have been living in most of my house numbers from childhood have always been 13 or they have been like this 48. So what does it show? That means we all have taken collectively, we have taken birth with certain script. That script we need to understand. What is that script? The script is optimal timeline reality. So we were all living in different timelines, meaning You are leading your life, Charles. Angel is leading her life. I am leading my life. We are all doing our thing. And some guys like me have taken the red pill early. But still, we were all in different paths or different life. And then one fine day, we are all coming together. So that together is nothing but 47. Yeah. That is why 47 is being repeated ad nauseum in the news. Also every... And blesses his disciples. So it is not related only to Hindu thing. And also one more famous quote in Bhagavad Gita is chapter number 2, again verse number 47. What he says is, Krishna says, Krishna, Christ, for me it's one and the same thing. You have a right to perform your duties, but you're not entitled to the fruits of your actions. Meaning, just do action, do your work without expectations. just to keep doing your good work. So this is also the second most, or the probably the equal most famous quote in the entire book. So just like Bible is holy for Christians, Holy Quran is holy for Muslims. Okay, for Hindus it is Bhagavad Gita, and it says karmanye vadikaraste na phalishu kadachana ma karma phala hetur bhur mate sanyosa sat karmani. It's also 47. You have right to. So that's why I predicted Swan will come, something will happen, some things definitely happened. And in fact, you know, now as you say that something is visible next to the sun, right? So all this is what?
Yes.
All making us go through the optimal timeline reality. It is telling us that we are on the right path. Isn't it wonderful? So that is the inner meaning of
it. Really is.
Yeah. And you will now start seeing automatically. So a lot of people are seeing 11-11, right? Lot of people are seeing 11-11. Lot of people are seeing 333 or 303. In fact, in the movie Matrix, the number 303 is where, you know, he gets his awakening and all that. Now look at this movie. I was actually watching a channel called UTV in the evening before our session. And this movie was coming. You remember, Charles, 2 days back, I told you that we are in the underworld. And this movie came as a confirmation. I'll tell you one important thing. So there is also a movie called Thor, the Underworld and all that. So I have actually found out that in the Ethiopia, the country Ethiopia, it seems it is 2012. So today, Pegum 6, the last day of Ethiopian year 2011 is ending and 2012 has started. So you may ask, or any common man may ask, what Ethiopia 2012? Tell me, like, what is the link? The link is we are in 2012. I was telling you the other day, Mayan civilization, and Mayans said that 2012, December 21st, something will happen. But actually, that much different important thing did not happen. It is happening in 2012 only. Just that we don't know when is 2012.
The right.
2012 right. is as per Ethiopian calendar. It is not as per the Gregorian calendar. Okay. See, date is September 12th. So we know that September 11th, what happened in America, right? 9/11 attacks.
Yes.
So 2012. So 2012 is 2020. And the proof is this movie, see, Underworld Awakening, it got released in 2012. Okay. Wow. And it got released actually on January 20, 2012. So see, 20 again. So that means 2020. They are telling you, see, 2020 is actually 2012. This is how the machines controllers encode. So 7 is coming. It means that we are awakening. When you see these dates, so never ever go by the Gregorian calendar. So of course, we don't know what is the right calendar. But the thing is, we have to keep doing our research so that, you know, we are getting closer to the truth. So January 2012. So somebody also told me, in fact, that, you know, the event in December actually happened on the day when I heard the sound in Bangalore. So that is also there in Hindu calendars, is that is called 360 days. So normally we take 365.25 days, right, for a year. But as per ancient Hindu calendars, Indian calendars, we take 360 days. We don't take 365 days. So even as per that, you can say that the event which was supposed to happen in December, it may have happened in May. I don't know. I have to go back and do the detailed calculations. But anyways, I'm just telling you. So this is one. Now, what is this Ethiopia thing? Why Ethiopia is so important? I'll tell you. This will, I hope, blow the mind of people. I did open it somewhere. Let me... just search. Okay, I will again open, no problem. Okay, now look at this. Cepheus, he is the king of Ethiopia. Okay?
Okay.
See? Cepheus is the Ethiopian. Okay. And he is near the pole star. See, Cepheus is a crowned king in royal robes whose foot is planted directly on the pole star or north pole. He participated in the graph of a tragic actor. So what are we seeing? We are seeing a lot of tragic news. So for example, so yesterday this became a mainstream news. There is a lady, she gave birth to a baby boy, and her name is Atira. Okay. And Atira's husband, who was trying to help a lot of people during the COVID pandemic, okay, trying, like Schindler, probably, he died of heart attack. So, which is a sad news. So, that is the tragic news. Okay. So, when you are becoming more and more conscious about, you know, the Matrix reality, the underworld, you will start seeing all these things. So, for example, George Headley died. Elephant died. Atira's husband died. Nitin actually means neo or new, right? Then, okay. So that is, the link is Ether. Now how it is Ether? Atira. See, her name is, just note her name. Her name is Atira. Now I will go to the constellation. So if you go to the constellation, the name Ethiopia from Greek means burn, I burn, to burn, face. It's believed to be derived from the Indo-European root word AI, to burn. Oh. Related words are ember, estival, estivate, heat. So what is happening, Charles? You know what is happening. So last year what happened? Arctic Circle was burning. In Australia, what was happening? The bushfires were
burning,
raging. What is happening in the entire world? The heat is going through the roof. It is summer,
yes,
all the time. The winter is less. It's always summer. Heat, estuary, edifice, edify, ether, etheric, ethyl, ethane, Mount Etna. And we know the story of Mount Etna. Akasha. Akasha means ether. And this is what Thor says in the end game. That ether or Akasha is not a stone. He corrects the other Avengers. Other Avengers, you know, they are asking him about, you know, time stone or is it space stone? Then he says, first of all, please stop calling it stone. It is not a stone. Okay. So Cepheus and Cassiopeia are king and queen of Ethiopia. Ethiopia is a cognate for aether. See, now see the word. A-I-T-H-E-R. Now yesterday or today, whose husband died? Aethira. So the matrix always talks to you, and like a cipher, or you have to decode it. What is actually happening behind that tragedies? So at one level, at an emotional level, you are very sad. You know, somebody putting a foot down on George Headley. You extremely rage, and then the anti-black movement, this, that, all things are erupted. But if when you go deep, you see that George is actually Saint George. And he is the one who actually killed the dragon. Now there is a new movie which came just a few days back. I think in Netflix or it came in Amazon. I don't know. Let me just show that also. Yes, it's a Netflix movie, Charles. The name of the movie is Choked. How often do you see Indian movies being named with English words? Choked. See. And when it released 5th June. Who is the director? Anurag Kashyap. What is the meaning of Kashyap? Kashyap is the father of all the humanity.
Wow.
Yeah. I'll show you. Kashyap Rishi. This is a, it goes very deep and very ancient. So unless you know all mythologies, astrology, you cannot, you know, get the, you know, what the hell is happening. See, Kashyapa is revered Vedic sage. Okay. He is the father of gods. He is the father of titans. He is the father of snakes. He is the father of eagles. He is father of everybody, basically. Even the Kashmir state of India, which is always into trouble, always people are like, you know, always fighting and always it's in trouble. That name comes from him, mm-hmm. Kashyapa Rishi. And it is also coming from Kashyapa Meru. In fact, Alexander the Great came to this place and he called it Kasperia. And it is also directly related to the ocean churning of the ocean, where the gods and the titans were going for nectar of immortality. So I was telling you about Rahu Ketu. This is the link. So that is what is happening. So whether you go by Norse mythology, Indian mythology, even Mayan thing, everything is connected to only one thing, which is ether. Because ether is Akash. Akash means Akashic records. What is Akashic records? Everything is stored, you know, when you die, when you are reborn or whatever. Everything is stored in Akashic records. Now, this is what Edgar says, Akashic records. Akashic Chronicle is a compendium of all human events, thoughts, words, emotions, everything. What am I doing? I'm just decoding this Akashic records. And there's a famous, I think he's an American, if I'm not wrong, Edgar Cayce. I don't know which country he belongs to. He explains the Akashic records. I hope you're still online. I'm not able to hear anybody.
Yes, yes.
Yeah, we're here.
Oh, you're so silent.
Yeah, no. We're following you.
We are spellbound.
So, can you see how I'm linking, Charles?
Yes.
Absolutely.
Edgar Cayce, see?
And all the breadcrumbs.
He's also called a sleeping prophet. He's sleeping.
Yeah, very well known.
Awake prophet. That's the only difference. And he.
Yeah, he would sleep and then he would channel.
See, March 18th. So when did India lockdown start? I'll show you something very, very interesting. So I think, 24th March, right? So 24th March, India went into a lockdown. And what is the sign on 24th March? It is Pisces. So I'll just show you that also. So normally, you know, when you see sun signs and all, people talk about Pisces, but nobody talks about Andromeda. Nobody says, I have Andromeda sun sign. Nobody says that. But let me show you this. So as per the sidereal astrology, this is showing the, you know, the Western astrology. It is showing as Aries, but actually as per the sidereal astrology, all this come into Pisces. All the stars of Andromeda. Because we have to subtract 23. So it is showing as Aries. So if you subtract 6, 23, I mean from 6, if you subtract 23, it is 6 plus another 17. So around 20 degrees of Pisces. So as I follow the Indian astrology system, so all this is actually into Pisces and Aries belt. And what is March 21st? Everybody knows that. Pisces sun sign.
Yes.
So it is between this February to March. And then Aries starts. So around that time, right? Around the Pisces time, the lockdown started. So there is a direct link to Andromeda. Now, who is Andromeda? Is a chained lady. What is chain? Lockdown. See, she is locked down. And who comes to rescue her? It is Perseus. So it is a Perseus who actually comes to rescue her. In which constellation did Atlas and Swan they go in May, the month of May? It went into Perseus. We don't know that. I have already talked about it so many times. And also, you remember, Charles, I talked about Mitras the other day. Mitraism.
Yes.
Mitra. See, that's also connected to this.
Yes.
It is connected to heavy rain. It's connected to Mitra. It connected to, you know, he undertook the mission to kill the Gorgon Medusa. He cuts off the head.
Incredible.
So what is Medusa? Yes. Everybody thinks Medusa is some monster or something. Medusa actually means illusion. So this there in, I think, Wrath of Titans or some one of the movies where it is shown how he actually kills Medusa is through using a mirror.
Yes.
Those who are movie junkies, they would remember this. Actually, what he does is he throws a mirror to Medusa. Actually, he's using the mirror to find or trace Medusa. And then what he kills her off. Same thing Arjun also does. Arjun, warrior, mirror. So the same thing is there in Indian mythology. So what this guy does, I think I've shown this in one of my earlier videos also with you, Charles, is that what he does is he hits the moving fish by looking at the mirror.
Yes.
Target.
Fish is again, yes.
A moving target. See, I think this is a good image. So he's looking at the water and he hits the moving target actually. And the award given for the best sports person in India is Arjuna Award. And the guy who actually won one of the, you know, he's won a silver medal in shooting. He was an Indian. Actually, India never wins any medals in Olympics. They always go and they get one medal or two medals. And one of the medals we won was a silver medal, I think, in 2004 Olympics. Rajivardhan Singh Rathod, he is a member of parliament. This guy. And he was an expert marksman. He actually missed gold by a very narrow margin. At world level, of course, a world championship and all, he has won a lot of gold medals. So I'm just telling you. So whether it is a Persian mythology, Indian mythology, Zoroastrianism, everything is linked. So that is what actually happened or started happening. Is there ascension codes and also, you know, probably cutting off the Gorgon Medusa. So May 20th, what the sound we heard in Bangalore was when does comet Swan went near Algol. And because Swan actually means sound and Algol means illusion. So the illusion started breaking. We also started collaborating more. We also started doing videos more. And
yes,
more revelations are coming.
And taking the mask off.
Taking the mask. Yes. Obviously, because everything is getting laid bare. I mean, how can, see, many people know, they troll me. I mean, not as much as in your videos, Charles. I see, like, you know, even for your chat videos, there are 5 dislikes. I wonder why. I mean, it's just a chat. It's not even a video, but people are disliking. In my case, they just come and say that, you know, I am connecting mumbo jumbo. I'm talking mumbo jumbo. Even though I'm showing direct proof. I mean, is there a coincidence between that lady's name being Athira and it meaning Ethiopia, it meaning 2012 being underworld awakening? I mean, how can anybody connect in one session 100 different things? Unless I'm super inspired or unless I'm really, as somebody says, I'm doing mumbo jumbo. I mean, what is mumbo jumbo? Where is the question of mumbo jumbo?
It's so new to them. It's just so new to them that they have to push back. And that's anybody who's disturbed by a reality other than their own is going to push back hard against your reality. And the more foreign it is to them, the harder they have to push back. They have no choice. True. They have to push back.
And coming to, you know,
data, shocking.
I think Angel has already covered about Lyra, you know, Lyrans and Vega, yeah. All that. So I'll just briefly talk about Vega star in Lyran constellation. It means Abhijit or victorious. And it also forms a beautiful triangle with other stars. And this is the star in which gods achieved victory against the Titans. That is why it is coming into consciousness. It's also known as Ma'at in Egypt. The vulture star, when it marked the pole. And what is the year? 12,000 to 11,000 BC. What are we talking about?
Wow.
We are talking about the return of good times. So
yes, the golden age.
Right? I cannot make this up.
No.
Even if I try. And see this movie. It's a British movie. Okay, Danny Boyle, who made an Indian movie also. Danny Boyle. He made a movie called Slumdog Millionaire. So he made this movie.
Yes.
Later. What is 28? 28 is 28 stars. As per the Indian astrology system, there are some people use 27, some people use 28.
Wow.
Can there be a better link than this? And it is what it is about. It is post-apocalyptic. What is happening? Apocalypse. What is apocalypse? Revelation or revelation. Apocalypse doesn't mean that, you know, people are going to die. It's actually, actually means that people are taking red pill. And see the color. It's red. The red actually has been wrongly interpreted as something negative. Oh, red signal, red this, red that. But actually red means?
Yes.
Revelation, red pill. Red is a beautiful color, actually. In fact, blue is what you say, blues. The song Blues.
Yes.
And see.
Sad. Down.
Yeah. This city, this city is being proposed as capital city of my state. Okay. Its name is Amravati. Actually, Amravati, as per mythology, is the capital city of heaven. So crazy can that get? Amravati, sacred city in Hindu mythology, it is celestial realm known as Indra Lok. Indra means the Zeus, right? He's sitting on elephant. Which animal died recently? Which made big news? Crackers, elephant. And the capital city of Andhra, my state, where I belong, it is Amravati. And what the hell is happening?
Oh.
And see this another thing, you know, which is which many people like from the word aether, Tara comes. Tara means star. It also means great wisdom goddess. So the root word of Tara or star, it actually means to cross. So I was showing the other day, like Jesus on the cross. What is cross? Crossing the plane. So that is the children of sun. So that is the Mayan thing. So I was showing you this book in between, the 2012 alignment. So 2012 alignment is still on. It's just that it is in 2019 or 20. That is the only thing. It is still on. Slightly that day. So they did say 2012, December 21, but just at 2012, as we know, is this year or the, which already happened. Pleiades constellation. All this we have seen. So in Pleiades only, right, we had that sound and whatever revelations are happening right now, all are happening in this only. Cameron Diaz becoming mother at 47. So this all I covered. I will just simply close this. So that's it. I think, Angel, you can continue with your presentation. I will just stop my share.
Thank you so much, Parth. That was incredible.
Yeah. Okay. So I am the host now. And Charles, I think you already know that Parthasarathi, the name and its meaning is Arjuna. Sorry, its meaning is Krishna. Can you hear me?
Yes, yes, I can. And you're right. Yes, Krishna.
Yeah, Krishna. Partha is Arjun and Sarathi. Arjun Sarathi was Krishna. So he also has this all, magnanimous connections. But definitely he hasn't talked about anything personal. personal horoscope. But anyway, so in consciousness is also, in consciousness also there is a renaissance happening, and it's definitely ascension into fifth dimensional earth, new golden age that is coming. And consciousness scale also, I also covered that day, what is consciousness scale. And directly I am going to Om. And see, the LOC of Om in the calibrated list is 740. That is also a bigger surprise. And 740 is 74 and it is 47. We see like that when we decode these things. Mm. So the mantra OM, it is slightly different than AUM. So we are not going to discuss about AUM. It is OM. Simply, it's OM. So this mantra OM, it has specific meanings. First of all, it's the absolute state. This is what the spiritual people ultimately aim at. It is a very peaceful and quiet state where one can free himself from all illusions and reach the highest state of spirituality. This is the oneness, Charles, that we have talked about. This is the oneness with God, a neutral position from where we can be one with the highest supreme energy, or what Ra has called as infinite intelligence. Illusions, Maya, this is what believed to distract us from attaining spirituality. This is the, you know, crescent moon. This is the symbology of illusion and Maya. And illusion definitely is the alcohol or the Medusa or the Maya or the lies that are going to be cut off by Perseus. The dream state, the dreamer is definitely the, what his name, I just forgot, just Patha told about the sleeping, what his name?
Edgar,
that person,
Cici.
He also, so he is also, he is always in the dream state. So it's like that the dreamer is believed to experience inner consciousness with closed eyes. The conscious state is there also. The individual in this state experiences the universe through his senses. This is said to be the most common human consciousness state. Om is the sound of the cosmic vibration of creation. So when we call the creation, it is also the creation of a new common timeline, that is optimal timeline. So is a common timeline where we used to live in a common place, in a common timeline. Like right now, Charles, you are there, Partha is there, and we are also, I'm also here, and all our chat group souls, they are also there. So we are all together in this optimal timeline reality. We are using co-collective consciousness to manifest the optimal timeline reality for Earth. That is very important. It's a common place. So what is 47 actually? I'm going to tell you.
Okay.
This is our interpretation on of 47. So that's a story. Main thing is that union of two prime creator souls, Lakshmi Narayan, Radhe Krishna. You can call them Adam, Eve. You can give any name if you want. Shiv Shakti. So 7 is Ketu, Ulta L or Ulta God. See, the name of Superman is also Karla L or AL. Yes. So you need to have different vision to see what is there. 47 is opposites union, Rahu Ketu union, brain and heart union, sun and moon union, your heart and your crown chakra union. So message is that if 47,
so for example, as she said, brain and heart. So Charles, in the chakra scheme of things, the heart chakra or the, you know, it's called Anahat, it's the fourth
Anahat chakra. Yes.
And the brain actually is called the crown chakra, is the seventh chakra. So when you say 47, yes, it also means this brain heart union. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. So whenever someone sees 47, definitely he is creating, and his mirror soul is also, his total self is creating a optimal timeline reality to reside there, because that's a story. So what happens once upon a time, I'm going to share a little story about 47, about Adam Eve, about the Shiv Shakti. So the divine feminine and the divine masculine, the primordial, not the general people. So once upon a time, the supreme divine feminine, who was abstract, was perfect, formless, non-existent existence, felt lonely. So she created one form, the first divine masculine for love and companion, the Brahma actually. After some time, many people call him with different names. So after some time, they again started living in different timelines, which they themselves created for each. The abstract divine supreme feminine energy created these two divine masculines and divine feminines for feminines for Leela or divine entertainment purpose. Just as we create one, online game character, she made this DM and DFs for Leela or divine entertainment purpose. As these two true lovers now departed, see, the thing is always in the present. So as these true primordial lovers now departed, so after living sometimes alone, they missed each other and decided to come together. And they created a new third common timeline where they reside right now. They had faced much without each other. They learned from their mistakes. Now they are in one common timeline. This timeline is 47. Four is Vishnu, Rahu, Shiva, Perseus, Brahma, maybe any name. And seven is Lakshmi, Ketu, Parvati, Andromeda, Saraswati. They have many names. They are multidimensional souls. But now in this 47 common timeline, the Lakshmi Narayan timeline, the 47 timeline, they are in full memory, full potential and full power, and they are the supreme primordial eternal prime creator twin flames 47 Lakshmi Narayan. And I also made a video on this, and these actually twin flame souls, it can be 3 persons, 4 persons, many souls, it doesn't matter, but their energy is like masculine and feminine energy, and combined they created one optimal timeline for residing in that common timeline. So this is very important. So that's our interpretation on 47, and we have like decoded this interpretation, or we have made this interpretation after watching many things, after connecting many dots.
Yes.
Yeah. And from the Great Awakening Map website also, that is there, people can go there and quickly they can watch what is the main gist. I'm not, talking about all the points, but the main point that we have discussed today. So across the world, millions are awakening to truth of reality. The Great Awakening Map is taking the red pill with no looking back. We have already taken that red pill. It emphasizes using our collective consciousness in constant meditation to manifest the optimal timeline reality for full disclosure.
Yes.
End of deep sleep. Definitely, we have to be ready for the great solar flare and already occurring solar system-wide evolutionary event bringing about spiritual ascension and ideally an activation of a light body. How to activate a light body, I already have given the links, and I also discussed in my video. So it's a wonderful time to be alive. World amen. Is peaceful now. Yeah, amen. And escape the matrix. Escape the matrix. Escape the samsara. And the in a final note, I want to conclude that it is very much important to balance this brain and heart. Actually, I want to say that it is very important to balance this red and blue. We need both masculine and we need both, feminine energies. Inside of our soul also, inside of our body also, there is yin and yang factors. We have both brains and hearts, and we cannot avoid a single one, or we cannot give emphasis or give extra chocolate to one of them. We have to balance both of them. That is the main message. Heart and brain, Rahu Ketu, opposites. We have to come to a neutral spot. That is the Buddha Phil Charles that everyone talks about. That is the point where God energy activates, and when you get one with the source, that is ascension, that is Kundalini awakening, and that is spiritual ascension.
And it's something that you have to make an effort for. It just doesn't happen. It takes practice, takes meditation. it is not an easy thing to attain. To be human is a struggle. To reach that divineness is of course utterly amazing. Yeah. But you just don't do it. Wake up, okay, I'm divine.